Running a small business is anxiety causing in and of itself, but when you add a pandemic, you lose sleep at night. My name is James Kim, and I'm an owner of a restaurant called Sons of Thunder, along with my brother John. COVID became real for us when a couple of friends of ours who owned restaurants in the Chinatown area of New York City started to see real dips in sales, and us being perceived as an Asian, at least a Hawaiian restaurant, we had the sinking feeling that we might not be too far behind them. Sure, what was going through my mind when you lose 70% of your business? It's hard to put that into words. You wonder, are we ever coming back from this? Is this the new normal? How does this work? I mean, the billion questions, rent, you know, how do you pay your people? You just keep playing it in your mind, you know. You start to get nervous and anxious about the long-term effects of something that we've never really dealt with before. As soon as stuff was happening, our faith community reached out to us, especially my pastor, Christian Hernandez. He pastors a church out in Astoria called Hope Astoria. He texts me virtually every day telling me he's praying for me, and he and Hope have been an immense source of support for me personally, and by extension, the team. You know, through one of the texts, Christian asked, hey, is there any way we can help the business? And then also, how can we help frontlines? And I said, well, you know, doctors and nurses aren't eating because, you know, they don't have the time even. And he floated the idea of making a donation to us to be able to feed some of them, knowing that we had relationships with NYU. So out of his own pocket, I think he donated something like $200. And we were able to feed about 30, 40 of the frontline workers with that donation. And we posted it on Instagram and through some of our channels. And over the past several weeks, we raised close to $30,000. And Hope Astoria eventually ended up donating another $4,000. And up to this point, we've done over 3,000 meals. That was actually pretty calm.
Pretty calm?
Yeah. I'm pretty proud of them. They had orders coming in on top, and yeah, they're good now. You know, this has been the drill for the past 2 months. Hey, Jen, this is James from Sons of Thunder. We're at the main lobby entrance. When you're as stressed as you are, as the frontline workers have been, to know that you don't have to think about food, you know, that day when you go into work is tremendous. To be fed is not just to feed your body, but your soul and your spirit. We really believe that. And so we've heard tremendous feedback from the front lines that it's not only practically supportive, but morale-wise, it's been huge for them. And I think there can't be enough said about being able to do something you love when everything around you is falling apart for some. And so we're so indebted to our community who have donated, you know, tens of thousands of dollars, not only to us, but other restaurants, to be able to not only support the front lines, but the restaurants themselves. We're just super, super thankful. And for our spiritual community who's been praying for us, supporting us financially, calling us, texting us, it's everything. Super grateful.